something that I care to share with you. And I know that it's the will of our Father that we totally trust Him. So in spite of circumstances, keep on lifting Him up. Patience you will find only makes your waiting seem so much easier. Leave things up to Him who is capable, knowing that victory is in His name.
Greetings and blessings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Brandon Clay, and I want to welcome you to the Main Street Church of God in Christ. Today is a very special day for myself, for my family, and our church, in that today we celebrate 3 years of service to the Main Street Church of God in Christ. And today is even more special, in that today we have set aside this time at 11 a.m. in this virtual setting to honor my wife, our First Lady, Lady Jessica Clay. She has been an amazing addition to my life and to the ministry. She has done so much to cover me and our children and to push the ministry forward. And she is a consummate lover of Jesus Christ, and she loves this church. And so today, we've set aside this time to show her some love and appreciation. And we thank God for you joining in with us. So as is our custom, as you're coming into the Cyber Sanctuary, greet someone. Let someone know that you're excited to see them this morning, because we are going to have some church. Do your part in digital evangelism. Like and share this morning. We're exceptionally excited about what the Lord is going to do in our lives this morning. This morning, we're going to hear from none other than co-pastor Pamela Woodall of the New Nation International Church. And I have to tell you that she is going to absolutely blow our minds. She comes to us every year, and every time she comes, she just absolutely wrecks the place. And we just thank God for the word that she's going to share with us on this morning. So get your pencil and your paper ready and prepare to hear an amazing word from the Lord. We are excited. The worship, the word is coming, and we thank God for this opportunity to celebrate our First Lady, Lady Jessica Clay. So stay with us, worship with us, and we're going into the sanctuary to our service already in progress.
Let us pray. Oh God, our Father, we come to give you thanks and praise you for your greatness. Thank you for our leaders today. Thank you for their devotion, their love, their teachings, and wisdom. I pray that your Holy Spirit empower them right now. I pray against any scheme or any temptation that may come against them. I pray that you send those that will encourage them today and every day. Lord, we're just asking you to continue to be with them as they continue to do the great commission that you have set before us. Lord, we're asking you again to cover them. And Lord, thank you for 3 memorable years. And Lord, we just ask you to continue to cover them as we go through many more. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
And a word from the Lord, coming from Psalms 1:1. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law do he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. And the word of the Lord is blessed.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Come on and put your hands together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to receive the glory and the honor. Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and bless the Lord with me. 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 Can't you help me say bless
the Lord with me?
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Oh, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
What's the highest praise we say? Bless the Lord with me. Help me say, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Oh, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
What's the highest praise we say?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Lord with me. Help me say, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Everybody say, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord with me.
What's the highest praise we say?
Hallelujah.
Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. Wave 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 your hands if you really love Jesus. Move your feet 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 if you really love Jesus. Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. Clap your hands if you really love Jesus. What's the highest praise we say?
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah is the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You gotta wave your hands. You gotta say amen.
If you really love Jesus.
If you really love Jesus.
If you really love Jesus.
Oh, if you really love Jesus. You gotta show some
signs.
If you really love Jesus. You gotta show some
signs.
You gotta wave your hands. You gotta say amen. If you really love Jesus. Oh, highest praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah is the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, if you really love Jesus.
If you really love Jesus.
If you really love love Jesus,
if you really 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 love Jesus,
you ought to wave your hands,
if you really love Jesus,
if you really love Jesus,
if you really love Jesus,
you ought to shout the sky,
if you really love Jesus,
if you really love Jesus,
if you really love
Jesus, oh, if you really love Him,
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 what's the highest grade we say?
Amen and amen. We are up to a very important part of the service, a very special part of our service this morning, and that now we have an opportunity to give tribute to our own Lady Jessica Clay. And there are some people who are coming after me who are going to do just that. But I just want to start off by saying to you, Lady Jess, that I love you, that I appreciate the mother that you have been to our children, the spouse and the companion that you have been to me, and the chief example to the women of our church. You carry yourself with dignity and class. You have an amazing sense of humor, and you have a presence about you that literally lights up an entire room. And I thank God for the opportunity to be able to do life with you in every and any capacity. And I thank God for you. And I can say without reservation that you have stood by my side and that you have experienced pressures as it relates to doing just that. And so my prayers constantly is that the Lord would give me the strength to be the covering in every sense of the word that I need to be for you. And I thank God for the opportunity to be able to do life with you. And so I thank God for you. I love you. And I'm praying that the Lord will allow us to see many, 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 many more years together as we lead this great church together. Amen and amen. All right. Now, here's some other people that love Lady Jess, and they're coming to offer tribute to her at this time.
Good morning, everyone. We greet you in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. We thank God for this day. For this is the day which the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. On today is a special day, a very special day. It is the third appreciation for our pastor and first lady, Elder Brandon Clay and Lady Jessica Clay. And on this morning, we are showing our love and appreciation for Lady Jess. We want her to know how much we love and appreciate her. And I feel honored today to have the opportunity to give tributes to my first lady, a beautiful woman of God. You know, she was new to this when she came to us. She and Pastor came to us 3 years ago, and I remember I greeted her, and I told her that just be yourself, and it will come. You will see and know how to be the First Lady of the Main Street Church of God in Christ. And on today, my tributes to her coming from the former First Lady of Main Street Church of God in Christ to the present First Lady of Main Street Church of God in Christ. You know, Lady Jessica is a beautiful person, a beautiful woman of God. She has a sweet spirit, a sweet smile. At times she doesn't say much, but when she does speak, she says what's on her heart. I find that she is a very genuine person. She doesn't put on airs. She doesn't put up a front. She doesn't try to impress anyone. She is just herself, and that's what I have always felt that she should be. For one thing, just being in the position of a first lady teaches you how to be a first lady. And she has taken her time, as I told her she should, and has come into herself as the First Lady of Main Street Church of God in Christ. She didn't have to please anybody else but the Lord and her husband.
And I tell you, she has done just that. And here within the last year, I can see where she has really come into that position. She has grown. She has matured. And she has gotten to the place where she's at ease and relaxed in being herself. As I stated earlier, she's such a beautiful person, both inside and out. And I like the fact that she didn't go overboard to try to impress anybody. She doesn't have to. All she has to do is to be herself. You know, one thing that the Main Street Church has learned over the past 3 years is that Pastor Clay loves himself some Lady Jess. He does. And he shows it all the time. And then she's quiet, but I can tell that she loves herself some Brandon too. Amen. Amen. And I think they are such a beautiful couple. They are such a beautiful family. Little Mackenzie and Riley, such beautiful children. And I can tell that Lady Jess is a wonderful mother. She loves those children, and she takes her time and teaches them and guides them and directs them. Make sure that they're okay. Make sure that they have everything that they need. She's a beautiful first lady. She's a beautiful wife. She's a beautiful mother. I believe she's even a beautiful daughter. From time to time, her mother visits us, and I can tell they have a very special mother and daughter relationship. So Main Street is blessed. We feel so honored to have Pastor Clay as our pastor and Lady Jess as our first lady. As I stated, she's coming into her own, and she's learning to be the first lady that God himself ordained her to be. Not following in anyone's footsteps, but just being herself. And she is the first lady that Main Street needs. Just like Pastor Clay is the pastor that Main Street needs, she automatically came right along with him. So she's the first lady that Main Street needs. Lady Jess, Main Street loves you, and I love you. I know where you're standing. I know what you face. I know what you're going through, and yes, at many times I know how you feel. I'm praying for you. I love you, and I'm praying that God will continue to bring you into your own and continue to make you who you should be in him. Continue to make you the wife that you should be and the mother and the first lady that you should be. One important job of a first lady is to assist her husband, to be with him, to encourage him, because she knows him better than anyone else. She knows what the load that he's carrying on his shoulders as the pastor of the church. She knows many times what's bothering him or what he's praying about and what he's longing to be able to do for the people of God. And she knows how he's striving to do what God has placed on his heart to do. And the first lady has to encourage and pray for and strengthen her husband and work right along with him in the ministry. And I know that she is doing just that. So whatever may come, Lady Jess, continue to stand by Pastor Clay, as I know you will, as you have these years so far, and I know that you continue to do that. Once again, I love you. I thank God for you. And I'm proud to have you as my first lady. God bless you, Lady Jess.
Good morning. I am grateful for this opportunity on today to give honor where it is due. I am standing on behalf of Mother Braxton, the church mother. She so graciously asked me to stand in her stead, so the words that I'm reading will be her own. To my First Lady, dear Lady Jessica Clay, first of all, I truly love the woman of God that you are and how you love us. The Bible says, with love and kindness have I drawn thee. I thank God for your meekness, compassion, your thoughtfulness, love, and concern for your members. You have been a joy to me, and I am proud to be your church mother. Lady Jessica, you have grown over the past 3 years. You came in and took a back seat as you supported the pastor, the church, and God's people. I thank you for your sweet spirit and the love you have given us. Lady J, from the heart, much does reach the heart. Iron sharpens iron. I thank you for your insight and your leadership. I thank God that you know who you are in Him. My baby, thank you for loving us and me. Knowing what concerns us, the church as a whole, I know it also concerns you. I noticed that you work behind the scenes. What is done in secret, your God will reward you openly. As you continue to work beside our pastor, I pray that the Lord our God keep you in perfect peace as you take care of those babies, the house, pastor, the members, and this great church. I love you, my baby. When I see you, I see your mother and how she instilled the fear of God in you. The fear of God is to love God and to love His people. I got you, Lady J. Just call me. With the help of the Lord, I will be right there. Remember, to whom much is given, much is required. You've got this, baby, and God has you. And again, I love you, great woman of God. Sincerely yours, Mother Braxton.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us here at the Main Street Church of God in Christ in our virtual sanctuary as we celebrate our third pastor and wife appreciation, honoring our own Pastor Brandon Clay and Lady Jessica Clay. Thank you for joining us on this morning. I'm here to give a tribute, amen, to our First Lady, Lady Jessica Clay. Before I get started, I want to read this portion of scripture. And it says, it's Proverbs 31, verse 10. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband do safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. And I'm going to go down to verse number 29. It says, many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. Amen. And we know that our First Lady here at Main Street is the epitome of a virtuous woman. Amen. And we thank God for her. We love her. I just want to just give a brief tribute to our First Lady. When we prayed to God for a pastor, we actually got a bonus because we got Lady Jess also. We are so grateful and so thankful to call you our First Lady here at Main Street. When I look for words to describe you, a few came to mind. Love. Your love for this church radiates when you enter the room. You express your love with the things that you do that we see and the countless things that you do behind the scenes. And for that, we say thank you. Another word is passionate. You are always passionate about what you do. You exhibit great passion and you work as unto the Lord. Whatever you do it wholeheartedly and as unto the Lord, and we say thank you. Lastly, and this is to echo what Mother Stocker said also, so we must have been on the same page. You are genuine. You are authentic. I recently read an article in Forbes magazine that listed the characteristic of a genuine person. And one of the characteristics is that they don't pass judgment. They're open-minded, which makes them approachable. So I know you get countless phone calls because you are approachable. We feel like we can come to you and share with whatever is going on. I know the young women of the church do. Feel like we can come to you and we can share because you are genuine and you are approachable. You're going to give us sound advice. And Lady Jess, for that, we say thank you. Another characteristic is that a genuine person forged their own path. They don't necessarily always go by the tradition, but they forge their own path. They know who they are and don't pretend to be anyone else. And Lady Jess, for that characteristic, we say thank you, and we are grateful. Genuine people are generous. Their unfailing generosity is exhibited in what they give, how they give to others, how they give of their resources, of their time. So the generosity in you, we thank you, Lady Jess. Also, they treat everyone with respect. No respect a person. Treat everyone with respect. Even when the children see you, their face just light up because you treat them with the same respect that you treat the mothers of the church with. And for that, we say thank you. They're not motivated by material things. And lastly, a genuine person is trustworthy. And we know that we have that in you. So on this morning, we salute you, Lady Jessica Clay, and we love you here at the Main Street Church of God in Christ. Amen.
God bless you, Main Street. We're so excited to be here with you all on today to help celebrate your leaders and our friends, Pastor Brandon Clay and Lady Jessica Clay. My name is Jaquetta Withers, and I have the honor of giving tribute to my friend, Lady Jessica Clay. Lady Jessica Clay and I, we hadn't been friends very long. We actually met through our husbands, but our friendship has blossomed through the couple years that we've known each other. Lady J has proven to be an awesome friend. Her kindness, her love, her openness. She's so sweet. Anytime I call her, she's always kind and willing to give me the information I need if I need strategies with my children. She's always there to answer any question I have, to listen to me vent, or be a shoulder to lean on. And I just thank God for your kindness. I thank you for being my sister. And also, I just love the way that you parent your children, your beautiful daughters, how you're raising them up. You're such an awesome mother. And it's undeniable your love for Main Street. You're such a wonderful first lady. You're doing a wonderful job. And I just thank God for you. I thank God for your godliness. And I just ask that you would just keep your head up, sis. Keep smiling. You're doing a beautiful job. I love you. God bless you. And I know that good things are yet to come for you. God bless you. And again, I love you.
My tears, the pain helped me overcome. Greetings. Hello, everyone. Bringing you greetings from the Main Street Youth Department. We are so excited to be a part of our pastor and first lady's third year anniversary. That's right, 3 years, the Trinity. We had to do things a little different this year because of COVID-19, but we dare not miss this opportunity, however that may be, to be a part. Immediately following this video, you will see a few greetings from some of our youth who just want to show a little love and appreciation to their leaders. Yes, our leaders. Again, we want to say thank you for your years of dedication, and we look forward to many more in the future. Cheers to 3 years.
Happy anniversary, Pastor and Lady Jess. And we love you.
Pastor and First Lady.
I wish my pastor and wife a happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. We love you.
You lift your hands. Oh, make us good ground, God. There's a blessing in the room today. Are you ready? Get ready. Already been released.
There's a blessing in the room today.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Get ready.
Get ready.
It's already been
released.
Oh, there's a healing in the room today. Are you ready? Already been released. There's a healing. Spirit is flowing. Whatever. It's here, whatever you need.
Is there anybody that's has opened. Anybody open? Even if he comes, if you're not open. What does it matter? One more time. Anybody open to receive?
Yes.
I need to empty out what's already in me. I need to make way. Oh God. I need to make way. I need to make way for him to release in me. I don't know about anybody else, but I need more of him. I got enough of the stuff, but I need more of him. I need him to release in me. I need him to open the floodgates. We gotta till the soil. We gotta break the ground. Ooh, okay. I gotta. Ooh, I'm trying not to shift. I'm here. But when you invite him in, you've gotta at least let him do what he wants to do. When you invite him. You've got to at least back up and let him have his way. Okay. And so we thank him. And he's here to meet the need. He's here to mend the broken.
And somebody else needs to know this. He's here to give you a second breath. Somebody in the house feels like if God don't resuscitate now, I'm not going to make it. But he's here. And he has the breath you need. Okay, to survive. Okay, we gotta shift. Yes, sir. Okay, I'm just, okay. All right, we gotta shift. We praise the Lord here. I'm trying, okay. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. One more time, just lift your hands and just shout, I surrender. Surrender, I surrender. I surrender. Oh, I surrender. Thank you. Someone shout, I surrender. Yeah. I need somebody else to shout, I give up.
Agenda. I give up. I give up my plans. I give up.
I give. Okay, God. I give. Okay. I give. Okay. You say your way? Okay, I give, okay. I give, okay. Now if you give, then he can. Y'all better sit down. Oh God, help me, Jesus. It's always good to be in the house of God. He makes his arrival. It's always good. He's here to meet needs. He's here. Because I have decided that I don't have time to waste. I'm older than I was when I came last time. And I don't have time to waste coming to a service and leaving the same way I came. I punch a time clock at work. But when I come into the house of God, I expect all of my needs. I expect all of my needs to be met. Because I know he can. And I thank God that he will. We honor the Lord in this place. We honor him. We honor the pastor, the first lady of this house. We honor them. We honor and we love them so much. We love them so much. We love them so much. And we honor my husband and my friend, Pastor Ramon S. Woodall. Can y'all clap your hands for him? And to the people of God, I'm talking so I can get myself together so I can do my speech. Because right now I could easily shift to something else, but that's not what we're here for. Oh, bless his name. I got a speech to do, and I need to make sure I'm not gonna be long, but I want to make sure, amen, the time that I do have, that I I want to make sure that the time I do have, that I can encourage somebody in this walk. Because these are trying times. And we need a word from the Lord. Anybody need a word from the Lord? Amen. We honor him. I feel him. He's here in this place. Repeat this prayer with me. Open my eyes that I may see you. Open my ears that I may hear you. Open my heart that I may receive from you and apply it to my everyday life. And we thank the Lord so much. Amen. This year, the theme is Bridging the Foundation and the Future. 1 Timothy 6:17-19. King James Version says, charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who giveth us richly all things to enjoy. That they do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to distribute and willing to communicate. Verse 19 says, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. And today I want to tag my message. I'm going to see if I can do it without glasses. I'm going to tag this message, Be the Bridge. Okay. I want to tag it, Be the Bridge. Now I have to tell y'all, I love bridges. I love them. I love bridges. I love watching documentaries. I love to see how they're built and why they're built and where they're built. My husband will tell you when we go traveling, I love crossing bridges. We went to Tampa and my feelings were hurt because we were going to go on the 7 mile, I think it's called the 7 mile bridge, and we ended up not being able to go. I love bridges. I love them. But what I discovered is that for a bridge to exist, there must be a divide. I'm sorry. If there is a bridge, then that means there must be a divide. And so I'm gonna give you an example. A road can take you anywhere. But once the land divides, a bridge is needed. Are you listening here? I need to tell you that it's important that in this day and hour, we need more of us to be bridges. I want to say it again. We need more saints to be bridges. We need more people who will connect the divide in our schools. We need more bridges. We need more people that will connect the divide in our community. We need more bridges. We need more bridges. We need people that will connect the divide even in our homes. Are you listening? We need more bridges. And can I even tell you, we need more bridges in the church. We need more bridges. We need more people that are willing to connect the divide. While studying the text, I saw that Paul charged Timothy to be a bridge. He first reminds him how he should walk and the character that he should have. And y'all know me, I love nuggets, so I got a nugget. Y'all ready? And man, let me see you before I hear you. We need more bridges. We need more bridges. Let me see your good works. Then I'll be open to glorify the Father which is in heaven. But I need to see your good works. And I know it's going to not sit too well with some people, but there are standards that we as leaders and believers should live by. Anybody agree with me? That there are standards that we should live by. You know, we live in a day now where people get offended when you talk to them about righteous living. Oh, can I get one witness? They get offended when you talk about righteous living. I can remember, amen, and I'm only 53, almost 54, but I can remember when I was living, when I was younger and I was doing things that I shouldn't do, amen, and then we go to church and it seemed like my daddy would preach, oh my God, on what we would... And I was ashamed. I was dodging bullets because I knew that the word of God was coming for me. But it was coming not to kill me, but to build me. Are you listening? When I love you enough, God loves you so much that he'll send you a word and say, I see you. And the question is, are you willing to get in line? But instead, we live in a day where they say, oh, they talking about me over the pulpit. And am I telling the truth? I know I'm telling the truth. Y'all have to say amen. I know I'm telling the truth. They'll say, they throwing rocks. But can I tell you, God just loves you so much that he don't want to see you go to hell. You know, it's still a hell. Okay. I know things are changing these days, and I didn't know whether there was still a heaven and hell, but I still believe in heaven and hell. Okay. And so we have standards that we have to live by. Can I give you another nugget? Without standards, we can't stand. Without standards, we can't stand. That's why so many people are falling by the wayside. They have rejected standards for living. But Apostle Paul reminds him and charges him to be the connection from the people to the truth. It's wrong if I can see you drowning and not reach out a hand to get you. It's wrong. And so we as leaders, we as first ladies, we as pastors must reach out and get them, but we got to tell them the truth. Yeah. Are you listening here? He told them that he has to be the divide between the people and the truth. He charged him to teach them. Somebody shout, teach them. He said, teach them that their riches shouldn't cause them to look down on others. Somebody shout, teach them. He told them to teach them to share with the needy. Somebody shout, teach them. He got to teach them to be good stewards over the finances. That's called good money management. I have my financial assistants here. Amen. They're always looking at new ways that we as a church can do things with our finances and you know, the givelifies and stuff. It's called good money management. Amen. We've got to learn, because y'all do understand in the scripture, we understand that you can't take it with you. So if you can't take it with you, you ought to plant a seed with it. Help somebody. You ought to help somebody. Hallelujah. In this walk, this is not a walk for selfish people. This is not a walk for selfish people. And so we've got to, somebody shout, teach them. Even earlier in the letter, he was telling them, he said, the love of money is the root of all evil. He was teaching him. He told him how to treat widows, and he told them how to treat orphan kids, and he told them how to treat the older women in the church. He was teaching him so that he could teach them. So here we are, and we have nuggets in our hand. We have nuggets that we're holding on to that we could be teaching somebody. Are you listening here? Okay, I'm moving. We as leaders and we as first ladies, we have to seize opportunities to teach. We got to teach, not our way, but we got to teach the kingdom way. Are you listening here? You know, just like mothers, we equip our children. Amen. We, as first ladies and the women of God, we've got to equip our Christian children. We've got to teach them the ways of God. Every member, no matter how old, no matter the position, should be teachable. I just told y'all, I'm 53 and I'm still learning. Took some online classes last year, taking some more this year because I want to know. And can I tell you, as a co-pastor, as a, in my position, I'm still teachable. I still sit down in minister's class because even though I've been in church all my life, every time I sit in the class, I learn something new. You got to be teachable. Somebody shout teachable. I was talking to one of my clients on last night. I was doing her hair, and she's a teacher, and she was saying these educators think our children are unteachable because they don't know a lot. She said, but they don't know a lot because they haven't been taught. It ain't no deep revelation. They haven't been taught. We have parents that send their children to school for the teachers to teach. And like you ain't supposed to do nothing. What happened to the day when you took a paper plate and you drew a clock on it? And you taught the kids how to tell time. That was when our parents taught us. They didn't depend on the schools to teach us. You know, what about the times when they would pour pennies out in the floor? You remember y'all used to sit in the floor and you had your legs open and all the kids be around. And they pour the pennies in the floor and then they'll tell you to count them. And then they would separate them and put them into groups. You remember they take the brown beans and the macaroni and put them in the groups. And they teach you about grouping and teach you. But what happened to that day? We're depending on everybody else to do the teaching. And then we're wondering why our members, we're wondering why our kids are learning the things that they're learning. It is because we're not teaching. But in this text, amen, we see that Paul is telling Timothy, you've got to teach them. You've got to teach them. You've got to be the bridge. And I promise y'all, I'm not going to be much longer. We must tell them, like 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 19, when you share, you are storing up your treasure as a good foundation for times to come. Because there are days are coming. There are days coming. Amen. We're in a day right now that none of us thought would be here. Are y'all listening here? We've gotten so busy and so self-absorbed that we've lost our compassion and sensitivity to the plight of others. But if it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, where would you be? Oh, bless his name. Oh, bless his name. I promise y'all I'm not going to be much longer at all. But today I've come to shake you. Today I've come to wake you. Today I've come to charge you to be the bridge. Hallelujah. We're living in an unexpected season. Times have changed. People are acting strange. But we've got to be the bridge to truth. People don't need another beat down. They need a hand up. I need to make sure that we understand that Main Street is going to be that place where people will come and not get beat down. They're going to be that place where they can see a hand, amen, and that hand is going to pull them. Are you listening here? Oh, bless his name. Oh, bless his name. God is looking for a people. God is looking for a people that will not beat them or kill them, but that will breathe life into them. Are you listening to him? We've got to be the bridge. We've got to be the bridge. We've got to be the bridge. We have enough dividers. We need some connectors. I'm going to say again. We have enough dividers, but we need some connectors. 1 Corinthians 16 and 14 says in one of the versions, let all we do be done in love. We've got to love them until they're not shamed anymore. Oh, bless his name. We've got to love them until they're not in pain anymore. We've got to love them until they forget about what they've been through and want to know about this God that we're talking about. We've got to love them. We've got to love them. It is our responsibility as a church and a people to love them. Are you listening? I'm almost done. I'm almost done. We've got to love them, and we got to show them the way. I'm standing right now because I was taught the way. Did I do everything right? No. But I was taught the way. And so even when I was in my sins, or the kids said, even when I was in my mess, I didn't forget about God. Because I knew that if I could just make it back to God, no matter what, I don't care how deep the waters got, I knew that if I could make it back to God. How did I know? Because they taught me. They taught me. They taught me. They taught me. You can start walking with me because I'm finna finish. They taught us. You know, my mother and my father, amen, the church taught us. They taught us how to pray. They taught us how to call on him in times of need. Oh, my God. They taught us. They taught us that it don't matter how bad you've been, God is still waiting on you. He's still there with his hand. He's still waiting. He's still there. He's still waiting for you to come to yourself. He's still waiting. And so we've got to love them enough to teach them the way. If we don't teach them, when they experience troubled waters, they'll be consumed. I'm going to say it another way in a nugget. I'm going to say it another way. When those who know the way don't teach the way, then you leave them to die in the wilderness. Just a little something soft. That's all. I promise you, I'm done. A little something soft. I'm done because I need to make sure. Yeah, Mikey, forgive me. I need to make sure, yeah, that we understand the responsibility of the church. I need to make sure that we understand, Nephew Pastor. I need to make sure we understand, because can I tell you that if we are not the bridge, then that means there is a divide somewhere that's not being met. Are you? Oh, God. I need to make sure that we understand that if we're not going to be the bridge, that we have souls falling in the water. Can I tell you that if we're not going to be the bridge, then who's going to save them? Who's going to rescue your son? Who's going to rescue your daughter? See, some of us, our kids are still small right now. I've been watching Faye. That thing is cute. Amen. But guess what? She's going to have some struggles in this world. She's going to have to deal with some issues. And we've got to make sure that we're the bridge. That when they get to the troubled waters, oh, bless his name. When they reach the troubled waters, that they have a bridge so they can cross over and not be consumed by the... be the bridge. We've got to be the bridge. And let me talk to the foundation. The foundation never hinders the build. I'm done. Never. The foundation just does what it was supposed us to do. And guess what? It's just supposed to lay.
God help me. God help me. God help me. God help me. The foundation. Don't tell the builders how to build. It just lay there.
So I told y'all I'm done. I'm done. I'm gonna give you this last one. And I'm finna walk out. My side. There is no future without the foundation. So we gotta be the bridge. We gotta bridge them together. But everybody gotta know their job. The foundation has to do its job, and the bridge has to do its job. But what I noticed about when they were building bridges is they start them off in many pieces. They start broken. But when the builders start putting the pieces together, it's painful sometimes when they begin to hammer the pieces together. It can be painful sometimes. It can be uncomfortable sometimes. But if you can just deal with the pain, if you can, the end result is always greater than the pain. Hey. I'm gonna say it one more time and I'm going to my seat. The end result is always greater than the pain. Just look at your neighbor and just say, be the bridge. 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 Be the connection. Be the bridge. Be the bridge of a troubled.
What a word, what a word, what a word. We thank God for the preaching ministry of co-pastor Pamela Woodall, and we thank God for the New Nation International Church for sharing and worshiping with us. That word was extremely powerful. Be the bridge. There were so many nuggets that she dropped in that time, but one thing that she said that just stuck to me is that there would be no need for a bridge if there were not a divide. And it just reminds me of Jesus Christ and the fact that when Adam sinned in the garden, that there was a great divide between God and man. But on a hill called Calvary, Jesus used a cross and he made a bridge to connect humanity to God. And we thank God for that sacrifice that he made for us over 2,000 years ago. But if you are listening to me now and you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that would mean that you have not taken advantage of that bridge that Jesus made with the cross. And so today we want to offer you that opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior on today. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 10, verse 9, that if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. And if you want to make that decision today, I want you to repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner, and I ask you now to forgive me of all of my sins. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He came, lived, died, and rose again with all power in his hands. And by believing in him by faith, I have a right to the tree of life. So Jesus, I ask you now to come into my heart to be my Lord and my Savior, and I will be your child. And right now, by faith, I am saved. And if you prayed that prayer in faith with all sincerity, right now you are brand new in Christ. And the Bible says, if any man or woman be in Christ, he is a new creature. And if you made that decision, if you accepted Jesus Christ this morning, I want you to put in the comment section, I accepted Jesus. You can also use that link, click to connect. Give us your information. You've made the first step, that you have accepted Christ. Now let's move on to the second step of renewing your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And we can help you do that. We can help you achieve your goals in God. Use that link, click to connect. Give us your information so that we can connect you with a body of believers that can help you to reach your kingdom goals and to reach your assignments in Jesus Christ. If the Lord has impressed upon you to be a member of the Main Street Church of God in Christ, put in the comment section, I want to be a member, and we will connect with you. You can also use that link, click to connect. Give us your information. We want to be your church family. I want to be your pastor. And if you don't live in the greater Pine Bluff area, that's okay, because now virtual membership, e-membership, is now an option for you. You have all the rights and privileges of all of our members in person. You have those same rights and privileges virtually. And God has given us the ability to use this technology to bring us together all over this great nation. So use that link, click to connect, and let us help you find your place here in ministry. If you want to sow seed into ministry today, if you want to sow seed into my life, to Lady Jessica's life, you want to sow seed into ministry, use that link, click to give, and you'll be connected to our secure online giving platform, and you'll be able to sow seed directly into us today. And we thank God for you. If you want to give via Cash App, use the cash tag $Main Street, COGIC. And you'll be able to sow seed directly into my life, into Lady Jess's life, into the life of our church. You'll be able to sow seed directly into us. We thank God for everything that you are doing and going to do. We thank you for worshiping with us today. And my grandmother always told me that people don't have to be nice to you. And so when they are, you ought to say thank you. So I'm saying to all of you, thank you so much. Thank you for showing my wife the love that you have shown her. And I thank God for an opportunity to be able to serve with such a great people. But before we go, Lady Jess is going to come with our final greetings this morning. We thank God for her. And we pray that you would continue to support us as we continue to support the ministry of the Main Street Church of God in Christ. But at this time, we will hear from our own First Lady, Lady Jessica Clay, and she's going to come in her own way. God bless you.
Greetings. My name is Lady Jessica Clay, and I would like to thank everyone who participated in our annual Pastor and Wife Appreciation. I am so grateful for everyone, down to the singers, the preaching, the visitors, everyone who made this a great day. I am just so ecstatic, and I thank you, and I love you. God bless.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you. Unto you, the Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. Ave, ave, ave.
Ah!